You've been pretty direct about the existential dilemma that combustible tobacco is facing. Where's your head right now on that?
Well, I mean, our objective is to phase out cigarettes worldwide as soon as possible. That's why we've developed a portfolio of alternatives that include e-vapor products, as you mentioned before, heated tobacco products that, you know, are existing in 48 markets worldwide. And just now, we are about to, you know, start commercialization finally in the U.S., following the FDA authorization that they're appropriate for public health. So I feel very good about the situation. But we also compete in the combustible business for as long as they exist. And in last quarter and since the beginning of the year, actually we're pretty happy because we have good performance in the combustible and much more importantly, obviously, very fast growth in our smoke-free products, including our product IQOS.
Is IQOS, what's the strategy in the U.S.? And is it your most important priority around the world right now?
Well, first of all, I'm very happy that we bring IQOS to 40 million Americans who smoke today. So we start with, you know, a test market. Actually, Altria, our ex-parent company, under an exclusive distribution license agreement, will do it. We start in one city and then we'll expand after that. But we need to learn first. To me, it's very important for two reasons. First of all, because we offer an alternative to the e-vapor products to the people who, and in case otherwise will continue to smoke, but also for the international perspective, a successful product in the U.S. obviously becomes, you know, helps the rest of the world.
What is Philip Morris's commitment to health overall? Because I hear you saying that the idea is to reduce cigarette use. There are some people who say the research is not conclusive that IQOS and heated tobacco is actually better for you. I don't know either way, but is there a standard that you're using on the products you release and a commitment to the consumer that's health specific?
Well, depends on, first of all, the research we've done in preclinical and clinical points to the fact that these products are better. IQOS is a better product than cigarettes, for sure. Now, the FDA has authorized the product, as I said previously, as at this stage, as appropriate for public health, and they are reviewing the modified risk tobacco product application, where clearly you can tell consumers in this country that this is better than cigarette when and if that happens. In the rest of the world, based on the regulatory regimes, we communicate to consumers the fact that it's better alternative than cigarettes, because that's essentially what the consumers need to know. Now, the standards applied are pharma industry standards, as I said, with preclinical and clinical. In IQOS in particular, we have a 90 to 95% reduction in exposure to chemicals compared to cigarettes. And all the other evidence points to a better product. And over time, as this product is adopted, and, you know, by the way, we celebrated 11 million users of IQOS last quarter, of which 8 million are fully converted and use exclusively IQOS. So we will have epidemiology to quantify exactly what is the reduction in disease and premature deaths, and then what is the absolutely clear impact on public health. But I think these products will have an impact on public health.